Hi. In this video, we are going to discuss about what is going to happen in testing phase, our phase. What are all the different phases it is going to involve in our testing phase? Here also, there are six phases will be there, right from beginning to ending of the testing phase. Those are test plan, test development, test execution, results analysis, bug tracking and reporting. Let we discuss these are all phases and then we'll talk about interview questions part. Test to plan. We are going to plan all the testing activities. We are going to plan all the testing activities. Right from beginning to ending of the project, this test plan will talk about who are all working for the project, what is in scope, what is out scope of the functionalities, whoever are involving, what are the softwares we are using, what are the tools we are using, when we are starting the project, when we are ending, what are the different deliverables we need to give it to the client, what is the bug life cycle, what is the resumption criteria or suspension criteria. These all going to involve in test plan document. Test plan will talk about all these things. So this most of the times will be prepared by test manager or test lead. Once this plan is ready and approved by the customer, then we are going to use this plan. Based on this plan, we will start the testing activities in our project. Test plan talks about each and everything related to the testing phase. So that is about test plan. Once approved by the customer, then we are going to start the remaining phases. Second phase is test development phase. Very important phase. Here we are going to work on developing the scenarios and test cases. Any requirement will be there. Let we assume some Bank of America is there. We need to test their application, their login functionality. So you know, right, in banking applications, so much security will be there. We are going to test the login page of the Bank of America application. In that application, high level, what are all we are trying to test it? First, we need to write high level. Those are all nothing but scenarios. Verifying the login page functionality with valid data. That is a scenario. Verify the login page functionality with invalid data. Verify the GUI of the login page. Verify the field level validations of the text fields available in login page. These are all the scenarios. High level what we need to test it. Based on these scenarios, we need to prepare our test cases. Test case is something like one verification point. It is going to talk about what we are going to verify on our application in low level. That is test case. In the test development phase, our job is to prepare the scenarios and test cases. Scenario is something like a high level verification point. Our scenario talks about high level what we are going to test it. Test case talks about low level what we are going to test under that scenario. So in test development phase, our job is to develop the scenarios and develop the test cases. That is job of a tester in the test development phase. And you may get a question here, how to prepare the scenarios and test cases? So rather than discussing how to prepare, for preparing these test cases and scenarios, as a tester, you need to understand each and every requirement very clearly. Then only you are in the position to prepare these scenarios and test cases. In the future videos, we will discuss more in depth about all this. Next, third phase is once test development is completed, next phase is test case execution. To perform the test execution on our application, we need to get the application from the development team. Once you get the application from the development team, you will start executing the test cases on our application. Once test cases you are executing, test case contains what is the actual result and what is expected result. Based on that, you can verify whether the test case is pass or fail. If test case is working according to the client requirement, then you can say the test case is working very well. If something is not working according to the client expectation, you think that the test case is failed. You need to send it to the development team for fixing. So, in the test case execution, you need to verify. Test case is something like set of steps. Something you need to verify on our application. A low level verification point is nothing but test case. We are deriving the test cases from these scenarios. So test execution is something like the steps what you have written in the part of test case you are going to execute on our application, and you are going to finalize whether the test case is pass or fail. If everything is working according to the client requirement without any deviation, then you can say that the test case is pass. Otherwise test case will be failed. So the next fourth phase is results analysis. You are going to analyze the results. What test cases are passed, what test cases are failed. If something is not working, what is your job? You need to send that issue to the development team. Let them get fix it. And then they will send it back to the testing team for again retesting. Then we are going to perform our retesting to confirm whether it is working fine or not. If again it is not working, again you will send it back to the development team without any hesitation. Our job is to maintain the or control the quality of the application. As a tester, you should not compromise with the quality. N number of times you can resend it to the development team until the issue resolved. So that is something about the defect tracking or bug tracking. Whenever any test case failed, you need to send it to the development team for fixing. That is something like bug tracking. You are going to track the number of issues what you are getting from the testing side. Once bug tracking is completed, okay, if everything is working fine, well and good, there is no issues are there. Finally, the job of a tester is reporting. You need to report because, as I told you, customer is more rely on testing team. Testing team should need to build the confidence to the customer based on quality of the application. Customer is more rely on testing team. We need to update properly updates to the client or customer. So last phase in the testing phase is reporting. You need to report every day or weekly or monthly to the customer what is happening on his application, or so how much is working, how much is not working, what are all the bugs we have raised, where those bugs are, it is retested, or what are all the functionalities are working, not working. Everything you need to update it to the client daily basis and weekly basis and a monthly basis. So that is something like taken care by the test lead in your project. That is something like reporting. So these are all the phases we are going to follow in the testing phase. Test plan, test development, test execution, results analysis, bug tracking and reporting. Okay, you have tested entire application, everything is working fine, well and good. There are no deviations and all the requirements are covered in our application. Okay, so in SDLC, last phase is delivery and maintenance phase. So if everything is working, there are no deviations, each and every requirement is covered, then we are going to deliver the application to the customer. The customer will start using the application. So next thing is, once he started using it, there may be a chance of errors in the application or we can call them as runtime errors. Or once you started using with the actual data, real-time data, then he may get a chance of some issues. Those issues we need to maintain it to the customer. Those issues we need to address from our end to the customer. That is something like maintenance. So these are all the different phases in SDLC. Requirements phase, analysis phase, design phase, coding phase, testing phase, delivery and maintenance phase. So these are all the different things. I hope you understand. Coming to the interview questions, they may ask in the interview, what are all the different phases are there? What is going to happen in requirements phase? What documents you are going to get it? Who will prepare the requirement document? What is SRS? What is FRS? What is BD document? What is going to happen in the analysis phase? When your team is going to build it, who will select the technology and environment? What is the importance of how you will build the confidence to the customer? How you will build confidence to the customer on his requirements based on the understanding document? Who will prepare the project plan document? What are all the different plans in project plan? Development plan will be there, testing plan will be there. What is the job of your architects? What documents they will prepare it? What is the importance of coding phase? Who will develop the coding? Coming to the testing phase, what are all the different phases in testing? Test plan, test development, test execution, results analysis, bug tracking, and reporting. Coming to the test plan, what are all the different things will be there in test plan? Who will prepare the test plan? Who need to approve the test plan before going to implement that? What you are going to do in test development phase? Preparing the test scenarios and test cases. What is scenario? What is test case? When you can able to prepare the scenarios? Without understanding the requirements, is it possible to develop the scenarios and requirements? What is test execution? There are sequence of steps in our test case. We need to perform those all steps on our application, whether it is working according to the client requirement or not. Similarly, what is going to happen in results analysis? You're going to analyze the results. What is passed? What is failed? What is reporting? Reporting, what is going to happen? Who will send the report to the customer? What are the different information we are having? Very simple. Test execution related, bugs related. Similarly, what is going to happen in the last phase, delivery and maintenance? We are going to deliver entire application to the client. The client will start using the application. If something is not working, from our end, we need to give support to the customer. That is nothing but maintenance. So these are all the different things going to happen in the SDLC phase. Hope you understand each and everything. Thank you so much. See you in the future videos. Thank you.